I'm back in the kitchen with another episode of Excel Hash. If you've no idea what I'm talking about, don't worry. It's just the second episode in over a year. So Excel Hash is a challenge between me and my online MVP colleagues. Each of us needs to make a video that includes four ingredients. We're free to use other ingredients to get the job done, but these four have to be integrated. The ingredients are at least one icon, at least one Excel dynamic array function, Excel's XOR function, and linked picture. Quite interesting. I think they're going to make a nice Excel dashboard. Let's try it. Let's assume I'm holding an Excel conference and a masterclass. I have the list of people in an Excel table called names that are attending the masterclass and the conference, and I track them using a flag of ones and zeros. So if a person has two ones, it means they're attending both the conference and the masterclass. I want to create an interactive dashboard that allows me to see who's attending the masterclass, the conference, just one of these sessions, or both of these sessions. Let's use the XOR function to figure out who's attending either of these. We get a list of true and false values. So we get a true if we just have a one on either side. We get a false if we have a one for both. Now, if you're familiar with Excel's logical test, you know that any non-zero number is a true. So in this case, we don't need to say equals one. To turn these into ones and zeros, let's add a negation here. Let's use a similar logic to calculate who's attending both sessions. Let's go and set up our dashboard. On the dashboard page, I've already have a dropdown for the different sessions that I'd like to track. Let's use the filter function together with the XLOOKUP function to get the list of people attending the session selected. My array is the list of names from the data tab. For the include argument, I'm going to use XLOOKUP. Lookup value is the value selected in the dropdown. Lookup array are the headers in the table. And the return array is the data set here. Remember, any non-zero value is a true. Filter is going to return the true values. Close bracket two times. Second ingredient is used. A dynamic array function, and we've even combined it with the XLOOKUP function. Let's add an index column here. I'm going to use the sequence function to get this done. Now, if I change the selection to both, this is a list of people who are attending both sessions. Now, let's add an icon for each of these sessions. On the calculation tab here, I've already added the icon or the picture I would like to have. So this one would be for the conference. This one should show up if I just select one from the dropdown. Now, let's add an icon for the masterclass. Let's use one of our ingredients, insert icons. To make this look better, let's convert to shape. Let's give the series a different color. We have one ingredient left. It's the linked picture. Let's create that now. I'm going to copy the cell, go to the dashboard side, paste linked picture. The picture currently is not dynamic. It's just showing me what is in the cell. So in cell A4, I have that conference picture. In cell A5, I have a word art. I want to make this dynamic, so I need to work with names. Let's go back to the calculation sheet. I've already given names to these cells. You can see them in the name box here. The name has to be identical to my dropdown that I have here. If you're using spaces, you can use underscores in the names. You just have to work with the substitute function later on in Name Manager. As a last step to make this dynamic, let's go to Name Manager and create a dynamic name. We're going to use indirect. Since our names are identical, we're going to reference our dropdown cell. Now on the dashboard side, instead of referencing to a specific cell, we're going to use the new name. If I switch this to one, the icon changes. Both, these are the people that are attending both the conference and the masterclass. Now it would also be nice to add a chart to this. Let's add the calculations we need for it right here. This is the total number of people attending, and this is the number of people attending the session we've selected from the dropdown. Let's finalize the chart. Now, if we switch our view to conference, This is the number of people attending the conference, and the number of people attending just one session is 29. So there it is, all ingredients together in an integrated solution. We even made it spicier by adding in a dash of XLOOKUP. Now here's where I need a favor from you. Watch all the videos in the Excel hash playlist. You'll find the link below and in the cards provided. Then vote for your favorite. I'll see you in the next video.